and you can shoot it into outer space.
Like, we're not one organism, we're billions of organisms, and our planet is also made up of tiny little organisms called humans, trees and animals, bacteria. But unlike the human, the planet has no central nervous system of its own. It has no knowledge of when something might not be working properly. So the answer, which is both extremely simple and intricately complex in detail, is for us humans, since we alone too seem to have evolved conscious thought, the burden is on us, especially if we want to survive, to build a robotic, automated, sensorized central nervous system for our planet. And it's the only way I can see our species surviving, because the planet will go on without us, but if we want to survive as a species, we have to align our actions with nature through automation.
Technology and automation is now growing at an exponential rate. It is incredible the things that we've created in just 10 years. We went from a bulky piece of brick that we can make phone calls on to mini computers that we can fit in our pocket, and you don't even need any buttons to work it. Farming, because of advancements in automation, instead of having an entire labor force working on a single farm, we have automated machines that can tend to hundreds of acres of land without any human assistance. Today, we have entire manufacturing plants, creating everything from the smallest computer chip to airplanes and automobiles. Airplanes have autopilot and need very minimal human interference to maneuver. Hell, we don't even have to have cashiers anymore. We simply scan the item, pay the machine, get your change, and leave. And these are only technologies we see every day. Audi now has a self-driving car that can maneuver any type of terrain and recognize when it's coming up on another car or when a sharp turn is coming up and the car slows down. There are machines that can now perform surgery on people much more accurately and precisely than any surgeon can. And most people are afraid of these new technologies because it will change their way of life forever. What they don't know is that that change will be for the better. It will relieve humans of jobs that they don't need anymore and they don't need to do. Instead of doing surgeries all day, a person can put his or her time and effort into discovering new and better ways to perform surgery, safer ways to perform, say, a heart transplant, or possibly collaborate with other medical experts to create a more efficient artificial heart. We need to embrace new technology in order to move humanity forward. Once we realize this, the possibilities are truly endless.
Machines being evil are generally, they always say, you know, like, you know, just the other day, actually, ironically, it was from a blogger from Ireland who was part of the libertarian Irish movement, and somebody put, you know, please help me refute this nonsense, you know, as a forum thread on Zeitgeist TV, and maybe, and the person said, well, having seen, you know, the recent Terminator movie, you know, this is the reason that I can't support the ideas of, you know, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And I'm just like, you know, you just basically debunked yourself right there. I mean, it could have been a movie about fairies or demons or anything like that, and it would have been just as irrelevant. In essence, when people are bringing up these conversations and they're quoting science fiction movies, they forget the fiction part of it, okay? And as you said about, you know, when science has been applied with a humanistic, you know, intention, then it's always been fine. You know, there is no evil science. You know, just like there's no evil in machines. You know, that's like saying that a missile is evil. The missile didn't choose anything. It was programmed for a specific purpose. It was given weapons. And then it goes to its target. It blows it up. The missile is not evil. The people who essentially launched the missile, they're the ones who you need to be worrying about as far as intentions.
Hi everyone, this is Douglas Millett, TZM Social Evolution on YouTube, the maker of Awakenings, the maker of our technical reality, anchor of a lecture that I gave to the Houston Humanists. Yeah, I'm kind of a busy guy. Not only that, a systems engineer with a space shuttle program. Although the space shuttle is going away, so that stinks. But that's not why I'm here. Technology has gotten to the point to where we can do so much more, and we're just simply not doing it. We're not doing it because of restrictions that we've put on ourselves. Restrictions that aren't natural, that served a purpose long ago, but serve no purpose now.
Let's get into the machines and how technology has affected everybody's lives, right? Let's start off with a coffee maker. Let's say everybody has a coffee maker, right? I have a coffee maker. In fact, I use it for hot tea now. I don't even use it for coffee anymore. But anyway, let's say you have a high-tech coffee maker. You program it to make coffee in the morning, and when you go to bed at night, you wake up in the morning, the coffee is made for you. You're not sitting there saying, the coffee maker's not saying, well, I'm going to go on strike. You know, I'm not getting much money. I'm not getting paid here. I'm making your coffee here. I better get enough money. And it's holding up a sign or whatever. Do you think technology is going to really do that to us? Do you think robots or machines are going to pull up a strike, say, you're enslaving us too much. We want more pay. We want paychecks. I don't think so. I don't think that's really going to be reality. Let's say air conditioner, for example. You program your air conditioner to set at a certain temperature, right? Now, does the air conditioner complain to you or say, I want a break. I want a smoke break. What about health insurance? What about medical insurance? I don't think the air conditioner is talking about medical insurance. Air conditioner does what you do with the would you ask it to. You program the air conditioner to set at a certain temperature, and it does it for you. Now, machines can break down, that's true, I agree. Robots and automation machines, they can break down. Now, what if there are machines or robots that can actually fix them for you? Now, I made a video a while back on robots, and it showed a housewife robot cleaning the house, doing laundry. Now, what if that robot was programmed to fix your air conditioner? Or maybe fix your coffee machine? Imagine that. A robot fixing all that stuff for you. People don't think of these things. They don't think of these ideas because it's too far out there for them. You know, when they go to work or they're seeing automation in big old factories, they're not thinking, well, how much automation? Wait a minute, I might be out of work next year because if this keeps up, there's not going to be any jobs left for us. That is actually true because we're in a technological unemployment. That's what it's called. And machines are taking over the jobs of other people. And so many people in the world today do not understand this. They can't comprehend it. When we're talking about sharing the world's resources with the inhabitants of the world, we're talking about sharing all the resources, the energy.
Famous people smile, celebrities that shine, the lives are in perfection, a bit for some attention, a figure out of fashion,
good tonight. They spend their money while innocent kids are dying.